from a professional photographer. So tips and tricks. What I would love for you to do, if at all possible, is to shoot in natural light. This is always the best thing. And we all know, you guys are fashion models. I saw something in the Neutrogena, room, and I think the Dove room, and she got a little zhuzh. Now, from a photographer's perspective, she's standing in a room like this, and there's a natural light window behind her. But she's in this room, and the hotel is in front of her, and she's doing a selfie, and all I want to think is like, girl, turn around.
Oh, it's a window.
But of course, I'm not going to say that because it makes me sound creepy. Like, I'm like, oh, turn around. Always point your face towards the light. Your back should be at the, if you're taking a picture of something, the light should be in back of you. And if you're taking a picture of yourself, the light should be in front of you. Now, if you're in full sun, and it's the middle of the day, and you want to get a nice outfit photo, go to open shade. Not tree light, right? You're going to be under a tree. Put the sun behind you so that you don't look like a leopard with light dots all over your face. One last thing. Let's talk about photography real quick. This is where I geek out. The sun is all around you. There is a shaded area here. Stand in the shaded area, but stand in a way that the sun is shining maybe on cement, like pavement, like a light color terracotta floor, cement. And that light in front of you is going to illuminate you like you're in a professional studio. So what you always want to do, find the shaded space, then look for the light in front of it. Don't step away from the light. You get just into the edge so that the light's right in front of you. It's illuminating your shoes, your legs, your outfit, all of this. And then you're lit like you're a photographer is bringing a whole light fixture, ring, and it's just what I call a natural reflector. Okay, also, best light at sunset, we all know this. Set your exposure manually. This is so simple. On your iPhone, you tap, you will see a sun. Get that sun and you push it up. If you want more light, get the sun and push it down. So swipe up or swipe right to make the photo brighter or darker as manual exposure on your phone. Big changes. If you want to take a picture of me right now and the light is mediocre, remember, there ain't no natural light, so it's all good. Let's pass. If we were outside and it's too bright, you want to go down. Too dark, you want to go up. Simple things like that. Keep your editing consistent. So I am truly a marketing writing geek. I read articles about Instagram. I want to understand the psychology of how people are really understanding the app and how they're in it. People prefer, 90% of people when they're shown images without filters. And I was like, what? But what I think is happening is when Instagram came out, they had all these crazy, gnarly, like, Kelvin, come on. You know, it's like, who's using this one? But we were so excited that we started applying these filters at 100%, but then people were like, that's not white, that's not what you look like. So, if you are going to use filters, there is something called opacity. Lower it down, really, really down. In fact, one of the best things that you can do is actually within the Instagram app. Take the picture, and the thing that I really just focus on is I raise exposure, I raise shadows. Why? Because nobody likes to look like a raccoon. So just raise the shadows, you raise the exposure, and then warm an image, like using the color palette. And then once I click on a color, I never leave it at 100, I dry it on back. Those are the things that I'm using in Instagram when I'm taking a picture from my phone. Very, very, very basic, but sit in that. That is what people prefer. I want you to explore. Give yourself the permission that even if you are a fashion blogger, even if you're a food blogger, even if you're a spiritual specialist, go out with your phone for 20 minutes as you walk your dog, shoot flowers, shoot water, shoot, and as annoying as it is, shoot your cappuccino, it's okay. But here's the thing, here's the difference between a mediocre Instagram photo or an interesting photo when it comes to cappuccino is if you take a picture of the cappuccino, okay. If you take a picture of a cappuccino with your arm swag, what kind of bracelets you're wearing, what rings you're wearing, do you have a cool new watch, do you have your sunglasses in the photo? Are we following this?
Yeah.
We have average? Great. Can you do those types of things? And you're very lucky if you're out with friends, or as I am conveniently, I'm an Instagram husband. You know, I'm like, oh, okay, wait. You know, so like, it's nice. Have a friend. pay it forward. You do what you want to do. Now,